first two segments of chapter 5, we're talking about special segments that can be drawn in triangles. And we've already discussed in section 1, the last two of these bulleted segment names here, that we've discussed the perpendicular bisectors of the sides, and we've discussed the angle bisectors. In this little video segment, we're going to discuss the first bullet up here, which is the median of the triangle. So first we'll define a median. A median is defined to be a segment that goes from a vertex of the triangle to the midpoint of the opposite side. All right, so here we have triangle ABC. We're going to construct the three medians. We can construct three because we can construct a segment from each vertex to the midpoint of the opposite side. So we could do that for all three vertices and all three opposite sides. So the first thing I want to do is find the midpoint where I'm going to be drawing these segments to. And so let me use my point tool on my GeoGebra, and I'm going to choose the midpoint tool. And I'm just going to click on segment BC, and that will place a point right at the midpoint. So point D is the midpoint of BC. While I'm at it, I'm going to go ahead and find the midpoint of the other two segments. You just click anywhere on the segment, and it puts a point right exactly at the midpoint. Now I'm going to construct the medians. I'll choose my segment tool. And for the first median, I'm going to connect point A, that vertex, to the midpoint D of the opposite side. And so there's a median of the triangle. I'll connect point B to point E, and there's a second median of the triangle. I'll connect point C to point F, and there's a third median of the triangle. And you will notice that all three of these medians met at a single point. Let me place a point right on that intersection. And so here, point G is the point where the three medians of that triangle meet. And no matter what that triangle looks like, all three of those medians will always meet at a single point, and that single point will always be on the interior of the triangle. And that point has a special name, and it's got some special properties, so let's discuss those now. All right, the point where the three medians of a triangle meet is called the centroid of the triangle. So the centroid is the intersection point of the three medians of the triangle. That's point G on this diagram. Now, that has some very special properties, and one of the properties has to do with how that point divides the three medians of the triangle. Let's take a second and look at this median that goes from point B to point E, and I want you to notice that the centroid point G divides that into two segments. There's a longer segment that goes from the vertex to the centroid, and then a shorter portion of it that goes from the centroid to the midpoint of the opposite side. And look at these lengths. This segment has a length of 2 units, while segment BG has a length of 4 units. The shorter segment is half the length of the longer one, or you could say the longer one is twice the length of the shorter one. That happens for all of these medians. It's a little harder to see with these where you've got the decimals, but this length GF is 2.38, GA is twice that, 4.76. GD here is 1.92, while GC is 3.84, which is twice the shorter one again. So you could say that the shorter portion is half the length of the longer one. You could say that the longer one is twice the length of the shorter one. Or the way it's normally said is that the shorter one then, if you look at the entire length of the segment, segment BE here has a total length of 6. That shorter segment 2 is 2 out of 6, which is simplifies to 1/3. So the shorter segment is 1/3 of the entire length, while the longer segment is 2/3 of the entire length. So we say that the centroid divides each median into two segments such that the shorter portion is 1/3 the length, while the longer is 2/3 the length of the entire median. Another important point about the centroid is that when you construct the three medians and you end up dividing the original triangle into 6 smaller triangles. Now, these triangles aren't congruent to each other. As we talked about in the last chapter, we couldn't use, you know, side, 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 or side, angle, side, or angle, side, angle, or angle, angle, side to prove that they're congruent because they're not necessarily congruent. However, they do all have the same amount of area on the inside. Here I've measured the area of all 6 of these smaller triangles on the inside of the larger triangle. all six of those triangles all have an area of 3.71 square units. So the medians divide the triangle into six triangles of equal area. Because of that, this median is often referred to as the center of gravity of the triangle, or the balancing point of the triangle. If we wanted to take this triangle and balance it on our finger, we would have to put our finger right there at point G. That's the point where we could hold it up and perfectly balance it at that point. So the centroid is the balancing point, or the center of gravity. And again, the centroid is found by finding the intersection of the three medians of the triangle, and a median of the triangle is a segment that goes from the vertex to the midpoint of the opposite side.